Welcome all, it's Russ. In this video, we're going to talk about while loops in Python. And this one won't be very long because you've already seen almost everything you need to know. If you want to go look at how to build conditions, you can go take a look at the if video. In Python, a while loop is simply the word while and then a condition. So we'll say while x is less than 100, let's replicate the loop over integers. X equals 0, x less than 100, print x, x plus equals 1, and that's your while loop. Something that you may have seen in some languages. A lot of you have not seen it in 110, but I'll give you a chance to take a look at it now, is the continue and break statements. So let's say that maybe we, I'm gonna have to change how I do this. Let's change this to put the x plus equals here before I do anything else. Which means, of course, that instead of printing 0 through 99, we're now going to print 1 through 100. But let's put in a continue. If x mod 2 is equal to 0. So hopefully you've seen modulo, but if you haven't, modulo is the remainder operator. So modulo is remainder. If you do 1 mod 2, you will get, let's not use an equal sign. 1 mod 2 will give you 1. 0 mod 2 will give you 0. Did an equal sign again. 3 mod 2 gives you 1, 7 mod 2, whoa, I wrote it, gives you 1, 8 mod 2 gives you 0. So this is just saying the remainder after division. So if you ask if x mod 2 is equal to 0, what you're really asking is this even? If it is even, then we will continue. Now what continue does is continue says, I want to keep doing the loop, at least maybe keep doing the loop, but I don't want to do anything more in the body. So this is really a jump statement that says jump back up to the top of the loop and terminate. So if we now have a print x, x will be set to 0 in the first loop. It'll increment to 1, this will be false, and so it will print. So it will print the value this will print out 1. Now it goes back up to the top. Now x is 1, that's less than 100, so it continues looping. X is incremented to 2. Now we say, is x mod 2 equal to 0? Is the value even? It is. So we hit the continue statement. We don't run the print, we just jump back up to the top. Now x gets incremented to 3. It's not even, so we print. So this loop will print all the values from 0 to 100, with 100 being inclusive, but it's only going to print the odd values. What if we wanted to do another limitation? Let's try the break statement. If x mod 17 equals 0, break. And now we'll say print x. All right, so in the first loop, x gets set to 1. So this is false. This continues to be false over and over and over until we've printed 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15. So we go through the 16 loop, we skip over the print there. But what happens when we finally increment x to 17? Now, if x is 17, this will be false. And now it'll check this. What's 17 mod 17? It's 0, because there's nothing left over. In other words, x is now a multiple of 17. What does a break statement do? Well, what a break statement does is it says go out of the loop entirely. Don't go back up to the top to see if you want to do more. So this loop says, theoretically, we're going to loop from 0 to 100, but we don't really. As soon as we hit 17, this loop ends forever. So this is this snippet of code. We'll print 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, and then end. All right, so that's while loop and also the break and continue statements. Hope this has been informative. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.